We are wrapping up the week with Walt Grayson. Walt is with us today, as he usually is every Monday and Friday to start and end our week. And we're going on a holiday visit today. It's a visit we used to make every year, but we sadly outgrew it, or so we thought. Mm-hmm. Walt, where to this time?
Well, Melody, not so much the particular location that makes it. That makes very little difference, actually. It's the person that we want to go see, and he is everywhere this time of the year. And perhaps beyond that, it's the spirit of the season that we're really calling on.
He's gone by many names down through the centuries in various countries. He's well-traveled. Kris Kringle, Papa Noel, Father Frost, Father Christmas, St. Nicholas, which we've skewed into Santa Claus. He lives at the North Pole and in that part of an innocent mind that's still open to dreams and wishes, the part not yet clouded by reality and robbed by time. We only had one Santa Claus in Greenville, where I grew up. He plopped himself down in his chair on the landing between the first and second floor of Sears and Roebuck downtown. Sometimes the line to sit on his knees stretched all the way down the steps, through women's shoes and men's suits and out the front door. And I knew most of the kids in that line, and if they were qualified, then it'd be a cinch for me to pass the naughty nice test. But there's always that small cloud of doubt. Well, this time, Santa invited us to visit him with his visitors at the Children's Museum in Jackson. Small, excited faces with hopes and wishes a lot larger than themselves. Anxious that they might not remember the whole list once they took their turn on Santa's knee, but trusting the giant elf would just know by instinct what was racing through their minds. You know, as writer Thomas Wolfe was the one who wrote down on paper the nebulous notion that we kind of already knew that you can never go home again. Well, here's a part of home we've had to leave behind us as we stepped out of toy land and into grown-up land. But hopefully we can still wish wishes and still have dreams for ourselves bigger than we are. But just to be sure, whisper them to Santa if you see him on the street.
Oh, I tell him all the time. Listen, we've got one of those dreams coming true. It's coming alive next Monday night right here on WJTV, our Christmas special of Mississippi Carol. A taste of what Christmas looks like and tastes like and feels like right here at home. And that's next Monday night, 9 o'clock.
I got a little sneak preview, and it is, oh, my gosh.
Can't wait
so
for it.
It's so good. Yeah. It's going to be a classic,
that's
really.
Great. You know, well, sometimes you want to escape adult land and go back to that,
oh gosh,
that childlike sense.
Every day when the clock goes off.
All right,
let's get a look
forward,
at the forecast
yeah,
for the Chief Meteorologist Kids South.
Looking forward to Monday, too.